Hello and welcome everyone. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works. And in today's video, we're going to revisit a topic that my colleague Austin Libel had done about 10 months ago around shortcuts in fabric. So what's this video about? Shortcuts in fabric. But we're going to look at the distinction between leveraging shortcuts within the files area within the Lakehouse, known as the unmanaged area, and the tables section within the Lakehouse, which is going to be the managed area. So stick around with me. We're going to learn the differences and make sure that we're doing things correctly so we can bring external data right into our fabric experience in that Lakehouse. Let's go check it out. All right, so we're here, browser of choice. I'm actually just right inside a fabric workspace, right? This is a workspace we've used in some of my previous videos here. Just got a Lakehouse. It has the capacity pool notebook from one of the other videos I had done. Seeing how we could control the creation of spark pools using the capacity versus workspace. Check that one if you're interested. But this one's all about this Lakehouse, right? We go in the Lakehouse, of course, we've got a tables area and we've got a files area. Now, just in case, the files area is known as an unmanaged area of the Lakehouse in which we effectively can just kind of bring whatever files we're interested in. Naturally, we want to kind of consider this OneDrive for our data. So we're usually going to be loading in things like delimited text files. You can see here, I have a Parquet file, right? File structures that you most commonly would associate with data lakes, right? When we ever kind of think about what we're storing there, but there is no limitation. You could really put whatever you need. Naturally, there are some specific features and capabilities that the Lakehouse leverages with certain data types like parquets and delimited files. We can drag and drop them over into the tables area and it will actually create a delta formatted table for us. It's pretty neat. Naturally, the recommendation here is for that Parquet file format, as it does remember, and it's a, like we've talked about, it's a metadata rich file format that has column headers, defined data types. So when you bring that over into that manage section, the tables area here, it's going to create a nicely formatted delta formatted table, right? So that's the key thing to remember here. The file section, unmanaged area for files. The tables area, the tables section, is the managed area. It's looking for delta formatted objects. And that is going to be the predominant difference here when thinking about shortcuts. Because if we go over and we just click into either of these sections, right? I go to table, boom, new shortcut. And I'll just click it initially, right? We're going to click right in here and take a look. Look at the options. I go over here into the file section and hit new shortcut. Let's take a gander here real quick. Exactly the same. So what are the differences? And once again, it is reliant on what the structure of the format is of the underlying information you're trying to create a shortcut for. Check out Austin's video as well, because he kind of covers the basics around shortcuts. But like I said, our focus is right here. How can we make it so that we can bring in something into the tables area as a shortcut and it works successfully? Well, just real quick, I do have a Lakehouse just over here, a data lake over here, just an external one that I've created. And we can see that I've actually got two folders, right? We have a files folder, which just has a Parquet file. Then over here, I actually have this folder I'd labeled Delta. And within there, I actually just wrote to this in a Delta format, actually a table known as dim customer. So this is what we're actually going to be bringing over. So that's what we're going to be leveraging. Now we've gone ahead and gotten some information here. This is something we'll try to make available for you in the video itself. We created a SAS token for access to this. So you should be able to get this as part of it. It might just require you to click on a little link to get the file itself, but this is the idea. Something that we've gone ahead of time, put into a Delta format, right? Delta Lake format, and that is how we're gonna be able to leverage this, right? Using, and like I said, if you watch Austin's video, we can go pretty straightforward, just go ahead, new shortcut, and we're just pointing to any blob storage account. You see the options we have available to us. So let's look over here and see how we can bring this right in straight up as a table, not going to the unmanaged area first. And then we can see it literally is going to be in our SQL endpoint. We can query it as if it was just a table here, which it kind of is. So let's go ahead and hit the ellipsis here. New shortcut. Now I've used this connection before. So what's going to happen when I put this in, it's going to pick that connection up, but that's okay. I'll say I'm going to make a new connection here. If I hit the data lake option, of course, all the other ones support it as well. We're going to use this data lake and I'm going to go to that file that we had there and let me go ahead and grab that URL, right? Pop that in there and you're going to see it's detecting that I've made this connection before. So what I'll do just so we can see everything, if I went ahead and hit continue, it would work because I've already put the SAS token in, but I'm going to hit edit connection. And just here, I'm going to place that SAS token, which was created with very specific permissions for a very specific time frame. And I'm going to put that in and we should be able to hit next. and we're going to be into our data lake. It is that easy and that simple. It's going to be the same even if you go the file route. So what we're seeing here potentially would be a list of containers. It would definitely be dependent on how that SAS token was created and what access we were meant to be granting. So I only have one container in this lakehouse. Very straightforward, very simple. I did create the token at that the actual storage account level. So in theory, if we add more containers, you'll actually see them, but we could granularly create a SAS token within the container itself. But if we expand this, there's the two folders that we saw, right? File and Delta. Once again, if I wanted to just bring that Parquet file, I think it was the dim day Parquet, I'd go to the file in the lakehouse, do shortcut exactly as we're doing, and just click on that. And we'd be able to bring it over nice and easy. But we're interested in straight up going in and creating a table for us in the lakehouse. That's what our Delta option is going to give us. So I'm going to highlight that folder. When I hit next, we're going to rename it, right? It just takes the name of this. Now, you know, potentially, depending on how you design this, right, you could have multiple items in here. But this is my dim customer table. So I'm going to label it as such. That's what I'm going to place here. And I'm going to hit that check mark. Once it's finalized, you can see it's saying it's good to go. Okay, hit next. And everything I'm telling you looks exactly the same, whether you're doing it in the file section or the table. It all lines up like this. But it's going to be nice and clean and straightforward, because when this is all said and done, we're going to see a new table that's going to pop up as if it's any other. Now, it's going to be pretty tiny. You might not be able to see it on my screen, but there's this little icon, almost like a paperclip showing its length, right? That is going to be our shortcut icon. And this is just a table now. It's right here. It's living in the lakehouse, right? We'll give it a moment for that preview to come up, but then I can adventure right on over into the actual SQL endpoint. And this is just a table ready to be used. If I right click it, we can go and view the properties of it. We can do maintenance, right? This created an underlying structure like it always would. It has all the information that we have from that shortcut, all ready to go. And like I said, it's here. It's ready to be used. I go to my SQL endpoint. It's going to be right here waiting for us. And we can write just some queries, right? I can go in here and say, hey, you know what? I'm going to put a new SQL query, and we'll just do something like a select star from our new table, right? Dim customer. And we're going to see that it's good to go. This has a customer key. So technically, we could join this with our internet sales table, right? That we could do a join statement right with that column. And all would be well and good. It would function. We could actually go over to the modeling tab, and I'll see it here too. And I could go ahead and add this to the model. This, for all intents and purposes, with the shortcut, has created a table in my lakehouse with a couple of clicks, super quick, and it's readily to be able to be used across every aspect of that lakehouse like we would want and we would hope, right? Making life easy. So once again, this is kind of that reminder, right? The thing around shortcuts is it's meant to kind of unify our data needs. If we already have some external sources with information that we want to take advantage of, whether it's in another lakehouse, whether it's in an Amazon S3 bucket, right? If it's in a data lake like this, depending on the format, right? If we have Delta Lake, we can bring it right into the tables area of a lakehouse. If it is just a file, remember you have to go to that file section of the lakehouse itself. But just a couple of clicks, we got our table. Pretty awesome. We got to make sure we're taking advantage of it. And as always, hope you enjoyed.